In another shocking case of medical negligence that has come to light, and this time it is from Bengaluru's KR Puram Government Hospital. Urban Deputy Commissioner, on a surprise visit, found medicines past their expiry date being given to the patients. It was also discovered that the hospital staff did not even have a register with the list of medicines in stock. The pharmacist and the superintendent of the hospital have been suspended. My colleague Neha Hebbale joining me live with further updates on this. Neha, shocking medical negligence. But first of all, help us understand, what were the findings when there was a surprise inspection that was done at this particular hospital?
Well, Apoorva, absolutely shocking, really coming to light here from Bengaluru, from one of the biggest government hospitals in the city, the KR Puram Government Hospital, where expired medicines were being distributed. And we're not talking about one or two bottles. These are multiple bottles of course, that amoxicillin syrup, and also now the antibiotic tablets also that were kept at the hospital had expired. While the expiry of course, the syrup was way back in July 2018, the expiry of course, these tablets was already in December 2018. So as we're given to understand now, of course, the DC Urban Vijay Shankar already carried out an inspection yesterday based on some complaints that they received, and later of course also he did realize that those in charge of course the stock of the medicines were not really of course doing their job to the mark, up to the mark. There was no registry also present at the pharmacy, and moreover, in fact, even of course the superintendent of the entire hospital was not even present at of course this hospital during the time of inspection. And when questioned, when of course he took all of these hospital staff to task and questioned them about the whereabouts of the superintendent, he was then told that he had gone to actually attend a meeting at the panchayati level, and it was later discovered that there was actually no meeting there. So he also now of course pulled up all of the staff of the hospital and questioned them as to why so much negligence is really coming into play and why they're not more of course careful about this. And going further now, it seems like inspection will also be carried out in many other government hospitals and ensure that all of the stock that's really outdated, all of this expired stock is removed at the earliest from the shelves.
All right, but Neha, let's just talk about the larger issue at this point. While we understand that there was an inspection done by the government itself and they found people who are negligent, they've suspended them. But a mere suspension might not be an answer. It is not going to serve as a deterrent because this has been working for quite some time. Is the government looking at any other checks and balances to put in place? Are they looking at a serious crackdown with a better deterrent in place?
Might at the most act as a red alert for the other officials in the other pharmacies who would now possibly maybe swing into action. But clearly that is not enough. And also the government should understand over here that with the problems prevailing at the moment already, with shortage of staff in many hospitals, with shortage of course, beds in many hospitals, and with all of these other issues that are already prevalent, they do not need another issue on their hands of expired medicines being used in the hospital or even distributed, of course, to the people that are really coming and buying these medicines or taking these medicines, of course, from the pharmacy. So this is just an additional problem that has to be addressed at the earliest, whose expired medicines could even prove to be fatal in many cases.
All right, we'll have to leave it there, Neha. Many thanks for joining us with those updates. Of course, it has to be seen what kind of crackdown and what steps the government really takes, the government of Karnataka really takes to put an end to such kind of menace and such apathy at the government centers.